All right, boys and girls, welcome back. Tone King here, coming at you live from the Tone Lounge. Get started with one of those bad boys right there. This is officially the last day of 30 Pedals in 30 Days. Today is November 30th. And rather than give you a review, I figured I would do a vlog. A video log to tell you a little bit about the event, how the event went. And I'm also going to give you a little bit of story time for those that have tuned into my live webcasts. I know I didn't have one the last Friday of this month, but it was a very, very hectic month. Hopefully you could all understand. But I want to tell you a little bit about what's on my mind, about 30 Pedals, how the event went, read you a little bit. And I'm going to wrap it up with the story of Randall Amplifiers, because Randall is the sponsor for 30 Pedals in 30 Days and has the kind of the winner for every day, which we have to go through now the event is over. And then all those names go in a hat for the grand prize, which is this exact Randall Thrasher that I was using for the whole event. So let me tell you a little bit about this. This is the write-up on thetoneking.com. I am totally plagiarizing right now because Mark Johnson wrote this for me. 30 Pedals in 30 Days 2014 was probably our biggest year yet. We had so many pedals to cover, we had to double up some of those days from big name manufacturers and some from dudes whose passion drove them to build pedals out of their own basement. Probably most impressive is that we had one of the coolest giveaways ever, which is the truth. Randall, who's always ready to step up to the plate and offer some of their most killer gear to fans of thetoneking.com. Randall has a lot of exciting things going on for it right now as far as amps. As of 2012, Randall has brought one of the biggest names in boutique amp building, Mike Fortin, as chief engineer. Mike Fortin cemented his name in metal circles with his company Fortin Amplification. Now his expertise is a permanent part of Randall's vision for the future. As far as you boys and girls, your response has been freaking awesome. We've got a ton of comments and a ton of positive feedback. You guys have always been the lifeblood of what makes thetoneking.com what it is. And that's why I'm plagiarizing. I couldn't have said it any better. If you're looking to do some catching up, you can find all of those links for all the videos below. So that's on thetoneking.com. Mark Johnson, thank you. He, for those that don't know, he did a write-up every day, including today, for the entire event. So Mark, thank you. I also want to thank Joe Delaney. Joe, from last year's NAMM, had stepped up to the plate and said, we're going to sponsor 30 Pedals in 30 Days again. So that was a really a big deal for me and hopefully for you all for thetoneking.com, that second year in a row. And this year was really exciting because, again, it's, you know, he did a Facebook post every day. We collaborated. We worked together every day. And it was really just tremendous, especially that it was during November, which rolled right into you know, Thanksgiving and the whole long weekend and all that. So very grateful for everybody that makes this what it is. Mark Johnson, Joe Delaney, the good folks at Randall, as well as you all, the viewers, for tuning in. So now let me tell you this. There were two pedals that actually didn't show up. Full transparency, which is, I always tell you guys the truth. There were two pedals that didn't show up. So I've been working with this company for a long time. They just released it. They were supposed to get it here just in time. So there would have been two extra pedals for the event that unfortunately just didn't show up, which is unfortunate. But I do promise to them and to you that I will cover them. It'll be outside of the event, but they will be covered hopefully in December. We just kind of ran against a window. With that said, I think the event was pretty badass. It was exciting. You know, I worked with guys like Master Effects and VainTap. These guys make pedals and like POB pedals. They have full-time jobs and they do this as their hobby, which is mind-blowing for me. And then we worked with some big names that, you know, they do this for a living, you know, big companies that make pedals. So it was really just a nice wholesome mix of pedal, the pedals that were covered, which is real exciting. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to wrap up with the story of Randall, And I'm wondering, you know, again, they sponsored the event, so I'd like to tell you the story about Randall, and it's pretty exciting. I'll also include that link below, but for those that like to just sit back with the headphones and listen, here you go. So, about Randall. The story of Randall starts with the history of its founder, Don Randall. Okay, Don Randall partnered with Leo Fender in 1946 to develop, market, and distribute Fender instruments and amplifiers. In 1953, he became president of Fender, and under his marketing genius, organizational expertise, and senior partnership with Leo Fender, Fender sales grew steadily throughout the 1950s and thrived well into the 1960s on an international scale. Don Randall coined the name Esquire Telecaster Broadcaster Stratocaster Precision Bass, also known as the P-Bass, Twin Reverb, Bassman, and others. Let me say that again. Don Randall, the amplifier company that we love and know, founded, coined Esquire Telecaster Broadcaster Stratocaster P-Bass, Twin Reverb, Bassman, and others. That's pretty damn significant in my book of rules. He also spoke for Fender in the 1964 negotiations that resulted in the company's sale to CBS, then subsequently became vice president and general manager of Fender Musical Instrument and Fender Sales Division of CBS until his departure from the company in 1969. Don Randall is forever rooted in American business as a pioneer in our industry and as one of the architects that contributed to the development of rock and roll. In 1970, he founded Randall Amplifiers with a focus on the technology surrounding the use of solid-state circuits. Remember, that was one of the questions. Solid-state circuits instead of vacuum tubes. Many of these early FET transistor circuits are still the benchmark for solid-state amps to this day. In 1990, Don Randall sold the brand to U.S. Music Corporation, who owns it today, in Wisconsin, who operated the brand until they were acquired by Washburn International in 95. Washburn International then renamed its operation to U.S. Music Corporation after the acquisition of Randall Amplifiers. 2002 brought the launch of the MTS. As a matter of fact, that's when I first started covering Randall, was during the actually, that's incorrect. I started, I think the RH50 was the first Randall amplifier that I covered. In fact, if you YouTube search basically that video, sorry, tangent. This is story time, so I could get away with it. It was like a 2008 video where it was like the breaking point between pre and power amp. And I wanted to show that every amplifier has that sweet spot where when you play with the volume low, it sounds tinny, but there's that sweet spot where it just opens up. And I use the Randall RH50. I still have that amplifier. It's in the vault. I still have that amplifier, by the way. Anyway, and then I covered the MTS line. So back to the story. 2002 brought the launch of the innovative MTS modular amplifier series designed by the former U.S. music engineer Bruce Egnator, who later found success with his own Egnator brand. After the successful launch of MTS platform, Randall greatly expanded its artist reach with Kirk Hammett, Scott Ian, George Lynch, and many others. In 2010, U.S. Music Corporation was acquired by Jam Industries, and Joe Delaney was hired to manage the Randall brand. Way to go, Joe. And let me tell you something. Joe is really just reinvented the brand as far as I'm concerned. Okay, back to the story. Understanding the need for solid engineering base from which to grow the brand, in 2011, Joe began to enlist the services of world-renowned heavy metal amp engineer Mike Fortin. The first order of business was to bring Metallica lead guitarist Kirk Hammett a new amp for his approval, and after that first prototype debuted at the Big Four show, Yankee Stadium, everyone knows that Randall was on track to renewed success. I didn't get tickets for that show. Nobody let me know about that one. Anyway, we'll let that go. In 2012, Mike Fortin became Randall's official new chief engineer. In the 2013 NAMM show debuted three new series of Randall amplifiers, the RG, the RD Diavolo, and the Thrasher. Series released to an overwhelming response from the heavy metal community. That, my good friends, boys and girls, is the history of Randall amplifiers. That's how I'm wrapping up 30 pedals in 30 days this year. And that's all I have for you. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. I am going to leave everybody, if you've gotten this far, congratulations. Here's the question I'd like to ask each of you, and you leave your comment below. I want to know what inspires you. What inspires me is doing this stuff. Making videos, sharing that with you all, telling the story about the products. I know, you know, some people say your videos are long, but I like to tell the story. I know not everybody wants to watch a 10-minute video, but that's what inspires me. And there are people that dig it, and that feedback inspires me. I want to know, leave your comment below, what inspires you? 430 Pedals in 30 Days, 2014. I am signing out, and I'm giving you all one of those bad boys right there. Thank you for watching. Thank you for participating. Rock on. Later.